In this video, we are going to see very important topic in analog electronics and basic topic, which is PN junction diode. In the last videos, we have already seen what is meant by P-type and what is meant by N-type. So now we are going to see what is meant by PN junction diode. So just once see the basic diagram. If suppose this is here, if you are adding suppose third P-type, this is, and this is suppose N-type. So in P-type, majority will be holes. Suppose this is N-type. In N-type, majority will be electrons. So this is the layer which separates P-type and N-type. This is the layer or junction. So this here will have fifth group element, and here we are adding third group element as impurity. Here the doping ratio is doping ratio is 1:10^8. That means 10^8 is the intrinsic atoms, and 1 is the impurity atom. The layer which separates P-type and N-type material is called junction. The layer which separates P-type and N-type material is called junction. Due to concentration gradient, that means concentration gradient means difference between the hole concentration here. If here the majority will be electrons, but minority will be holes, like this. Here the majority will be holes, but the minority will be electrons. So because of this, there is concentration gradient difference is there. So here the concentration of electrons is more, here the concentration of electrons is less. Here the concentration of holes is more, here the concentration of holes is less. So due to this concentration gradient across the junction, due to concentration gradient across the junction, the charged particle diffuse from one region to another region. So the charged particle diffuses from one region to another region. That is what will happen. Electrons from N-type, always the diffusion from higher concentration to lower concentration. So that is electrons from N-type to P-type and holes from P-type to N-type. So that is electrons from N-type to P-type and holes from P-type to N-type. So due to this, what will happen? Due to this, recombination takes place. That means electrons and the holes will recombine and the depletion region is formed. So what is meant by depletion region? The region in which there is no availability of charged particles. So due to this, recombination takes place. And depletion region is formed. So what is meant by depletion region? The region in which there is no availability of charged particles is called depletion region or barrier. The region in which there is no charged particles is called depletion or barrier. So to make the current conduction, if we want to make the current conduction, the PN junction diode must be biased. That means, so you have to remove that depletion region. So depletion region is due to majority carriers only. Always the depletion region is due to majority carriers. So to make the current conduction, the PN junction diode must be biased. That means depletion region should, the width of the depletion region must be decreased. So we have seen that to make the current conduction, the PN junction diode must be biased. So there are two types of biasings. One is forward biasing and another one is reverse biasing. So let's see first what is meant by forward biasing. Take a PN junction again. So this is P and this is N. So P will have majority holes, N will have majority electrons, and this will have minority electron, and this will have minority hole. If I am applying external voltage here, such that P type is connected to positive terminal of battery and N type is connected to negative terminal of battery. We always know that like charges repel, unlike charges attract. So here, holes are nothing but like positive charge. Electrons means negative charge. So here, like charges will repel. That means holes will be repelled here. And electrons will be attracted by this battery. It means electrons will be attracted and holes will be repelled. Similarly, in N type, electrons will be repelled, holes will be attracted. So this is the variable voltage. In shortcut, this can be written as, so PN junction diode symbol is this one. This is given to positive and this is given to negative. So this is P, this is N. These both are identical. All the minority carriers moves away from the loop. If you observe here, this is a minority carrier in P type and hole is a minority carrier in N type. So these are moving away from the junction. They cannot form loop. So all the minority carriers moves away from junction. They cannot form loop. So if they cannot form loop, means the current contribution by minority carriers is zero. So you can write simply, I means current here, I minority is equal to zero. All the majority carriers are moving towards the junction. If you see here, all the majority carriers are moving towards the junction. All the majority carriers moves towards junction. So what will happen? If I am increasing the voltage, as voltage increases, repulsion forces to majority carriers increases. That means depletion region width decreases. So as voltage increases, repulsion force to the majority carriers increases. If the repulsion force increases, the majority carriers are moving more towards the junction. That means depletion region width decreases. Why? Because what is meant by depletion region? where there are no charged particles. But if the repulsion increases, the charged particles tries to enter into the depletion region. That means the width of the depletion region decreases. So as we goes on increases the voltage, the depletion region goes on decreases. And at some particular voltage, depletion region width reduces to zero. At some particular voltage, depletion region width reduces to zero. Then the charged particles start crossing the junction. Then the charged particle starts crossing the junction. So the voltage at which the charged particles start crossing the junction is called cut-in voltage or threshold voltage or barrier voltage or depletion region voltage or knee voltage, anything you can say. So I'll repeat again, the voltage at which charged particles starts crossing the junction is called cut in voltage or threshold or barrier voltage or depletion region voltage or knee voltage. So any of the name is correct. So it is represented by V gamma. So generally V gamma for silicon is, that means for silicon diodes made of silicon requires 0.7 voltage. And V gamma for germanium is 0.3 volts. So if the voltage is increased beyond cut-in voltage, the number of charged particle crossing junction increases. As voltage increases beyond V gamma, number of charged particles crossing junction increases. Current through the diode increases non-linearly. So then that is given by ID is equals to I naught into e power Vd by eta Vt minus 1. So what each term signifies means I naught is nothing but reverse saturation current. We'll see about this term in next video. Reverse saturation current. And Vd is nothing but voltage across diode, that means what is the amount of voltage you applied, voltage across diode. Eta is intrinsic factor and this intrinsic factor depends on type of material. That means for silicon eta is 2 and for germanium eta is 1. So eta is equals to 1 for germanium, 2 for silicon. And Vt is nothing but thermal voltage. Vt is K into T by Q, which is thermal voltage. Here T is nothing but temperature in Kelvin. So Vt is equals to KT by Q, T temperature in Kelvin by 11,600. It can be written as K by Q. I written as 11,600. So if you take the temperature is as 300 Kelvin at room temperature, VT is nothing but is all approximately equal to 26 millivolts. It means voltage equivalent to temperature, which is 26 millivolts. So this is about forward biasing.